mother, I was off for my first day of
is Jeannie Skinner, and she's escorted by Bob Heath. Jeannie is acting in volleyball and shooting.
Okay. Our third candidate is Muffy Swanson, escorted by Sean Sinitra. Muffy Swanson is active in cheerleading and gymnastics.
Next candidate is Chrissy Joseph, and she's escorted by Stuart Sundom. is active in student council and NHS.
Our fifth candidate is Kathy Bona, escorted by Paul Trajek. Kathy Bona is active in gymnastics, cheerleading, and boys basketball.
Okay, our sixth and final candidate for this year's 1987 Homecoming King and Queen is Becky Rongrud, and she's escorted by Dave Brenning.
Off your back. Well, come on and let me know. Should I stay or should I go? Should I stay or should I go now? Should I go now?
Joseph and Dave Brenny, and we'd like to have some thoughts on how they're feeling right now. Dave?
It's really honored to be chosen the king. I wasn't really expecting it. I was kind of surprised. Somebody didn't tell. I hope that this year is good. I hope we win the football game too. And I'm really honored.
All right, thank you, Dave. Chris, you have a few words?
Yeah, I can't even explain it. Just like Dave, I'm so surprised to get something like this. It's like the best feeling. I really love Fridley and everything that goes on. It's just fun to be a part of the school and a part of homecoming.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, we're over here at Tina Olson's house, and this is the secret place where they are creating the senior float.
My name is Bob Heath, and our theme this year is Toast the Tornadoes, and I brought the tornado.
Thanks, Bob.
Go ahead, Tina.
My name is Tina Olson, and this is my car that we use for the tornado carrier.
Yes, it worked.
I'm Lonnie Gilbert, and I brought the 87s.
I'm Jill Langner, and I brought the staple gun.
I'm Christy Tollickson, and I just came to help.
I'm Lainey Sorensen.
I'm Laura Verdon, and we brought all the stuff.
We went out and bought the supplies, and we're currently working on a piece of toast.
I'm Tracy Salo.
I'm Kathy Black.
We stole the 87 size from Spur gas station. Thanks, Spur, for the 87.
Come here.
I'm Bill Egan, and I did everything here, you know.
I'm Dave Brulette, and I helped him out.
Well, I hope we win in Friday night. I know because not that good, but I hope we will win. Maybe we'll make two wins. Maybe we'll score a touchdown. I know we haven't scored that many. We're coming out with some different things. You'll be surprised. And some of you will be really shocked what Bob's doing. But yes, he is changing the offense a little bit. And I hope to see everybody out the game.
All right, well, thank you very much. And good luck to Fridley. Let's hear it now. Everybody cheer.
With this year being the last year for the
Sorry, I turned off my fit.
He'll tell you after you get past that he ran out of film.
Ta-da!
Thank you.
Okay, we're at the Fridley Junior Senior Prom, and we are talking to two of the girls that were in charge of the festivities for tonight and their dates. And so they'll introduce themselves, and we'll start right here.
Hi, I'm Laura Verdon. And here's
Billy Egan.
Hi, I'm Chris Joseph.
And Brian Kaw.
All right, do you want to tell about the band and how and all the things that you did to prepare for this?
One of 100. We found the band. The band's name is Real to Real. The place we're having it is called In the Mood, and it's down here in Dinky Town. It's worked out really well so far. I'll pass it to Christy and let her say something. Okay, well, I think we're all pretty much having a good time. We also have a gift certificate for dinner for two at Tequila Berries for one of the couples. Overall, we're having a heck of a time.
Are you guys having a good time today?
Yeah, we're having a great time. No one else did. It's a good time.
87 rules.
87 rules.
All right, thank you very much. What's your name?
Kim Walgren.
John Woodward.
Are you enjoying yourself this evening?
Pretty much so.
Definitely.
How's the band?
They're really good, actually. They sound pretty good. I mean, close to the bands that actually play the songs.
Okay. And you are a senior?
Yeah, I am.
And are you in school or out of school?
I am in school right now.
Okay, what year are you?
I'm a sophomore.
Okay, well, thank you very much for this interview. All right, here's two fellas here, and they'll give their names and tell us what they think of this prom.
My name's Paul Trachik.
My name's Daniel O'Keefe. I think the prom's going real good. I think this band is just... I'm impressed.
Yeah, me too. Nice atmosphere. The, food's good. Punch, it's also good.
It's free, too. Don't forget free.
Free, that's the best.
Makes it cheap. It's one time, too. The band is moving. The people are getting into it finally. It was slow getting going, but now it's hopping.
One thing wrong, though, is it's a little hot in there, so we come out here and step outside for a little bit of air.
Yeah, cool down a little bit, too. Back to our MC for a second here.
Thank you.
Hi!
You done? Try it again, because I wasn't at your face.
Oh. Hi!
I'm Charlie Ross, and prom is great. My girlfriend and I here just won a gift certificate for $25 at Tequila Berries.
I'm its girlfriend.
I'm Lainey Sorensen.
Everyone knows my name.
I'm Jill Langner.
I'm Tracy Salo.
I'm Christy Tollerson.
How's prom going?
Great!
All right, I'm talking with Sherry here. Are you enjoying yourself tonight?
Yeah.
And do you like the band?
It's okay.
What is your name?
Greg.
And are you out of school now or what?
Yeah. You can say that.
What do you do?
I'm a bum. For a little while ago, and I've just been bumming around.
I see. Okay, well, thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Sandy Schweigert, and I'm having a good time.
I'm Newman, and I'm just sweating. Big time.
I'm Rachel, and I'm having a good time.
Take the mic.
I'm Dan Schmidt, and I'm having a good time.
I'm Mickey Welch, and I'm jamming.
I'm Brian John, and I'm having a blast.
I'm Troy Melton, and I'm casual.
I'm Jean Myers, and this is unreal.
Have you enjoyed the year at Fridley this year, and have you all the activities and so forth, and are you all looking forward to graduating?
Well, my year at Fridley has just been incredible, I'll tell you. This last year has just been so great.
It's just been a blast. We can't wait to get it over with.
20 days left and counting.
What is that, 23 hours? 20 days, 23
six
hours?
Times 20.
Don't give it to
you. Sure?
Yeah.
Oh, you can't. You're not a senior.
Yo, not a senior. The year's gotten really fast, huh?
Seniors rule. Are there any other comments you can think of, you know, the things that maybe that you enjoyed about school or whatever?
Nope.
I really miss Dr. Engelson tonight. I wish he could be here.
I'll miss Lou's test so much.
Mr. Erforth, this one's for you.
Just two words, cutting weight.
I'm all done.
Mick rules. Thank you. Out here, and they're all sitting here, and they look kind of, it's 10 minutes to 12, and they all look kind of tired, so maybe they can introduce themselves. And
Carrie Bryan. Oh yeah, but it's too hot in here.
There's Kathy Black.
Who don't it? Oh, it's lots of fun. I'm having a good time.
Sandy Dorcas, I'm having fun.
Are you all tired or are you just taking a break?
Tired. It's really hot. My feet hurt. Oh.
My feet hurt.
Are you tired?
Yeah, my feet hurt.
All right, thank you very much.
Verdon, and we're here in Mr. Meyer's office, and we're going to be doing some interviews here, and Mike Gargaro will be interviewing Mr. Myers.
Thanks, Laura. Mr. Myers, what are some of your memories of the class of 1987?
Michael, that's an interesting question. I think
The class basically has been just a delightful class. I'm going to do a little politicking here for a minute, but I really mean it. This is only my second year as the principal, so maybe I don't have quite as much to draw from as past principals, but I can't imagine a better senior class. I think starting right back with the fall, we've had some enthusiastic support of our activity programs. I'm as serious as seniors ever are. I think they've been really serious this year and have had a, frankly, an uneventful year in terms of disruption. I think the performance of kids in classes has been excellent. We've had our moments, okay, and we'll probably have a few more before this year is over, but with a few days left, my memories of this class are really positive. I think they've been involved in activities. They've been serious around school, and yet it's been a fun environment. And they've done some things that have really added to our school through our senior social studies classes. I think maybe in some other parts of this tape, there are some comments about the Women's History Month that came out of social studies, the SAD chapter activities, our student council activities. I'm going to miss some clubs and I'm going to be in trouble for it, but the key club kinds of things, all of the athletic programs, there are really some outstanding things that have been done by a variety of activities and kids, and the seniors are always the people who contribute most to that. And so those things we accomplish in a given year are generally driven by the students in the senior class. Okay? So that's my basic memory of this class. It's very positive.
All right. And then if you had any advice for the class of 87, what would that be?
Do I have to be completely serious? No, I can joke a little bit. But if they continue to be like they are, they're not walking around, or you guys aren't walking around with your hands folded. I know that. You know, you're not just, you're full of fun and full of life. And I guess if I would encourage you to continue to live that way for the next 7-8 years at least, things will really turn out very well for all of you. I have a private theory that I developed as an assistant principal. And that is that by the time kids are 25, they really have their lives sorted out pretty well. And that a lot of times was said to parents who were awfully worried about kids who were constantly in my office. But I think it's good advice for this class. Work awfully hard between now and the time you're 25, and the rest of your life is really going to be in awfully good shape.
And what do you think of the class of 87?
Well, without rehashing some things, and as I'm looking at some of the people who are here in my office right now, it's a awfully good class. I'm going to stay with generalities because it's hard to get specific unless you start commenting about individuals, but we've got a class of leaders. We've got a class of good students. We've got a class of kids who have achieved an awful lot while they've been here. And so I have awfully positive feelings about the class. But generally, now I will get really general, I think we've been so fortunate in Fridley to have the kinds of kids and families that we have. The kids in this class are the way they are because of the parents they have. And as you know, I've been in Fridley a long time and I think very highly of it. But I think that I have the same feelings about this senior class. I think very highly of them. Going to miss you. Okay? 29th class of Fridley High School. I've seen them all graduate. And I'll remember you fondly. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate the opportunity.
We're here now with Mr. Barnett in his office, and Nikki Joseph will be interviewing him. Here you go, Nick.
Mr. Barnett, how do you...
I don't think I know you.
Yes, you do know me. How do you think the scholarship banquet went?
Well, I think the scholarship banquet went very, very well. This year we were able to give away a total of $29,000 to the graduating class of 1987. It's probably the most money given away to the scholarship program of any school in this area. And that's a real credit to the service groups and the businesses in Fridley.
And what do you think about the ordeal of having two valedictorians and two salutatorians?
Well, it's an amazing thing that happened. You know, when we keep students' records, we go out to the thousandth of a point. And we keep your records from ninth grade through seniors. And the fact that it came out even for valedictorian and salutatorian is almost a statistical wonder that that would happen. It's only happened once before where we had co-salutatorians. We've never had co-valedictorians before. Just one of those things that happens.
Is there any advice you can give to us, the class of 87?
Yes, hang in there. Remember I told you in our pre-interview, I do not give advice. I only help you make decisions that are best for you. But I think this class is good. It's a class that has done well academically. And I think the best advice is that every student like yourself, Nikki, should use your best potential, which you have plenty of, and give yourself 100%, and you'll all be successful at something.
Thank you, Ms. Barnett.
Well, thank you for interviewing me.
Here at the busiest office in the school with one of the most important people, Shirley, and Dave Brulette is going to interview her.
Shirley, what are some of your fondest memories of the class of 1987? It's a tough question, I know.
The students themselves are very important. I'll miss them.
That's sweet. What, if anything, are you going to miss the most of them?
Them coming in every day, chatting.
Okay, you're going to miss everybody.
Everybody, right.
Well, that's nice. Thanks a lot.
Nicole Joseph, and we're here in Dr. Ingvilson's office interviewing him. Here's Paul Trocek to ask him a few questions.
Hi, I'm Paul Trocek, and this is Dr. Ingvilson. He's the vice principal of our school. What do you think that the class of 1987 is well disciplined?
Well, by looking at all of your hands, I would have to indicate that you're probably not. I mean, there's four of the more respected students in the class, and they're all down here on discipline or attendance referrals.
So what do you think about this new attendance policy they have in the school?
The new attendance policy doesn't work.
And?
Why?
It's a real problem to administer, too many students are in school all the time, and I have too much problem controlling them now.
Well, I don't think I agree with it either, because I have four in one class, and
okay.
If I miss it again, I'll probably fail.
That's good, and I'll be the one that'll have to assign that. That's difficult to do. No, seriously, the attendance policy does work, and your class has been a tremendous class and a real asset to Fridley Senior High School. I've been proud of your class and all the students in your class this year, and there's been very few seniors that have been referred down to the office consistently for, I've had a few that have come down once or twice.
Dave.
And they've, no, not Dave either. Generally the entire class has been respectful and has showed good citizenship in the school. And I commend you and your class for that. And as far as the attendance policy go, it does work. It's a pain for you as a student, and it's a pain for me a lot of times to administer it, but our average daily attendance has increased, our grade point average has increased, and we attribute that to the fact that you people are here.
What is the deal with this popping these milk cartons in the lunchroom?
Danny can give us the best answer on that.
I think Danny O'Keefe can give that. He has lunch with the principal every day now. he has a pretty good understanding of what happened.
So why would you stamp your foot down on just something that...
I ask, why does Danny stamp his foot down on the milk carton? Right. That's a good question.
Well, fortunate.
No, we won't talk about your fortunate.
So what kind of advice would you give to the seniors, graduating seniors?
Be careful, have fun, and good luck. I think that you're a class that we're going to be able to look back on in 10, 15, and 25 years that has been successful. You showed that you can be successful. You're competitive. You've had a successful year academically, athletically, in music, drama. And we're still one of the smallest schools in the conference. And you people have competed very well against them. And that says that you have some real fiber in you that's going to make you a success out there in the world of work and in the business world. And I wish you all the luck in the world.
Thank you for taking your time.
Thank you.
And I never thought I'd feel this way. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm glad I got I should ever go away. Well, then close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. And then if you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me for sure. That's what friends are for good times and bad times. I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for. Well, you came and opened me, and now there's so much more I see. And so by the way, I thank you.
Oh, and then for the times when we're apart, well then close your eyes and know the words are coming from my heart. And then if you can remember, oh, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me for sure. That's what friends are for. In good times, in bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. Oh, that's what friends are for. Keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count me for sure.
What is your name?
Amy Hollis.
And what is the most memorable thing about Fridley High School?
Oh man, the most memorable thing about Fridley High School? Help me out, you guys. There's too many to count, really. Techniques of theater has always been good.
All right, do you want to pass this mic down and have everybody introduce themselves?
Okay, you guys, you gotta introduce yourself and say the most memorable thing about Fridley High School.
I'm Tina Dennis.
What? I don't know.
I don't know, a lot of things. Not big one thing.
Feelings.
Go ahead.
Should I say my name?
Chris Sahola. I'd say the friends and just being together with everybody.
Oh, jeez.
Becky Ronrud. Everything kind of just mixed together, dances and being with your friends and always knowing that they're there, and let's see, student council, stuff like that. I don't know everything.
Sandy Dorcas, the most memorable thing to me are the friends, the friendships and relationships that you, people you get to know.
My name is Kathy Bona, and one of the most memorable things from high school is our 1986-87 football season.
Say that, Essex.
sample of the lunches, and they look real good to me. I don't know what their problem is, but I'm going to pass the mic over, and some more girls joined us, so they're going to introduce themselves, and maybe they can tell a few things about Fridley High School that they've enjoyed.
My name is Muffy Swanson, and I guess the best thing about it was friendships that I made and the sports that I was in and getting to know a lot of people that I didn't know before, and that's all.
The most memorable thing for me is all the new people I met this year and just having a lot of school spirit for the class of 1987.
Having all my friends and being able to go to sporting events and stuff. And the lunch is not as good as it looks.
All right, what is your name?
Jason McCarty.
And what is the most fun that you've had this year, moments that you can recall that have been, you know, at Fridley?
I don't know. I like everyone in school and going out with everybody on the weekends, pretty much.
All right, my name's Chad Richam, and I'm going to Hennepin Tech next year to take carpentry. And I don't know. Fridley's, I think, is a pretty nice school. And I don't know what to, pretty glad to get out of here.
We have a bunch of girls sitting over at the other table that are all pointing at this fellow. They all want him to be on this tape, and so we'll ask him his name and what
is your name?
My name's Tim Schweppe.
And what are you going to do after you graduate?
I plan on going to St. Cloud and get my master's in funny car driving.
All right. What is your most memorable moment about Fridley?
Probably Ing. He's been a nice guy to every one of us, each and every one of us. Really liked the guy. Wish he could come with us and, you know, help us out in school later on, too.
Tell him where you were last Saturday.
All right. Where were you last Saturday night?
I can't remember.
Too tough a question. Okay. Thank you very much. I'm talking with the president of the student council. He's going to introduce himself and tell us what his impressions of Fridley.
Oh, I'm Tom McEverick. Hello. My impressions of Fridley. I don't know, good school, I suppose. What else can I say? I can't say it's a bad school.
Okay, do you have any advice to give to your fellow seniors?
Advice. Just be happy. That's all you can do. Be happy.
That's good advice for anybody. All right, and what are your future plans after you leave Fridley?
I'm going to go to the University of Madison in Wisconsin, and I'll study engineering.
That's great. Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
I'm here with the editor of the yearbook, and what is your name?
Karen Schuler.
And how is the yearbook coming along?
Oh, we're probably as good as we're going to get right now. We're doing fine, rushing to get everything, last-minute things done.
Okay, and do you have any special advice for your fellow seniors?
I think go out and have fun and make the best of the end of the year and all the years to come.
All right, and what are your plans for the future?
I'm going to go to the University of Minnesota at Morris for at least probably the first 2 years, get a biology degree and go into pre-med.
That's wonderful. Well, good luck to you in the future.
The knife.
Again, I'm here with Mr. Liu, and I'll be interviewing him about some of his favorite memories of the class of 87. Mr. Liu, can you remember any memorable moments from your classes of 1987?
Well, I remember, first of all, that there were a lot of good times in the classroom. The kids had a sense of humor, and we did some funny things. I remember the dances, because I chaperoned all of them. I remember getting your kids to count the money. The prom, worrying about the prom, and that. Do you remember that? Whatever it was.
Rainbow arch.
Right. Remember that? Remember, it fell down.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I guess. The most important thing I remember about the kids was that they were really good in class. It was really a lot of fun having them in class.
Great. Is there any general comments you have on the class of 87?
No, I think they're really a good bunch of kids. I think they'll all do well. I'll look forward to seeing them, seeing what happens to them later on in their lives. I think a lot of them will come back very successful and very happy. They were one of the best groups I've had.
Great. You're a famous one for advice. Would you like to send us off with any advice?
Well, just be yourselves. And, I don't know, don't take life too serious. And buy a dishwasher, right. What? Yeah, drop me a line sometime. I appreciate that.
Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Lou.
Thank you.
You bet. We're here with Mr. Peterson, one of the favorite senior social teachers, and Dave Burlett will be interviewing him.
Mr. Peterson, seeing that this is our first year of the SAD program, how do you think it's progressed through the year?
Well, I'm really proud of the kids and their involvement in SAD, and we had a couple people, Melissa Martins and Laura Zerby, that put a lot of effort and time into this, and since it's in memory of Jenny Heimstead, we're very proud of what we've accomplished. We won a scholarship through Reader's Digest, and Laura and Melissa are going to get a $500 scholarship each for that.
That's great. What are some your favorite memories of the class of 87?
Let's see. Favorite memories was co-starring with Nicole over there and being able to sing to her in a couple years ago and being in the play this year. Those were fun, being in the variety show with a bunch of other teachers. And generally, I think the class of 87, we've had some good times, and there's some good kids in there.
That's good. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
With us here is Miss Nelson and Laura Verdon. Laura's an interviewer for our class of 87 memory state.
Hi, Ms. Nelson. The reason we're having you here is because we had an interesting new thing this year was the Women's History Month, and you were in charge of that. And we'd like to know some of what went on with that.
Well, at the high school, there was really two major events. The first one was Anne Bancroft coming in, and her presentations to the school were just terrifically well-received. And that was really the highlight. But the second big event that happened at the high school was we had about 50 women from about 40 different careers come in and share information with students about those career opportunities, anywhere from engineering to child care to teaching to the medical and legal professions. And we got really good feedback from kids about having an opportunity to talk about careers, and we did it with Women's History Month because it was a way for all areas of the curriculum really to be involved in celebrating the contributions of women. In social studies, we talked specifically about women's contributions in history, but Career Day gave us an opportunity to look at all aspects of our curriculum.
And I think everyone appreciated how well that went. Thanks a lot for your effort with that. W Cubed and Dan O'Keefe, and he'll be interviewing Mr. Winholtz.
Hey, babies. I'm here with the big triple dub, the head honcho of mathematics in Fridley High School. He knows everything. He does magic on the blackboard. You have to see this guy work. He's amazing. But I'm going to interview him right now and ask him a couple questions. First off, Mr. Winholtz, what is your general opinion about the class of 87?
My experience with the class of 87 is in the calculus students, and this is probably the best calculus classes I've ever had.
That's it? That's all you have to say?
What can you say if you've already said they're the best?
That's right. I think we are the best. I mean, he teaches us so. I mean, the reason we're so good is because he's so good. We wouldn't be where we are without you. Second of all, I'd like to ask if you have a few of your fondest memories about the class of 1987.
Well, the fondest memories of the class of 87. Generally speaking, I'd say the class of 87 has been a very responsible, well-behaved group of seniors. It's not the biggest class we've ever had, but it's been one of the most enjoyable from my standpoint, and I think talking to the other teachers, they feel generally the same way.
Yeah, that seems to be the general consensus today. And third off, I'd like to ask you if you have any advice to give to the graduating seniors for their later lives.
Well, I guess primarily I would say don't sell yourself short. It always has bothered me when I see, and again, I'm talking primarily about math students, but when I see a student who has a lot of ability and 10 years later I ask them what they're doing and they're still checking out in Cub or something like that, and I think a lot of kids don't do as much as they are capable of doing. They should probably strive for higher goals and attempt to be more than they think they can be.
Well, thank you, Mr. Winholtz. That's all I have to ask you.
We value your advice and we value your opinions. Thank you very much.
Hi there. We're here with Mr. Georges, one of our handsomest, funnest,
thinnest,
and favorite teachers, and his favorite class, the 6-Hour Speech Club.
Yeah!
And Paul Trocek will be interviewing him.
My name is Paul Trocek, and this is Mr. Georges. So what do you feel about the 6-Hour Speech Club?
It is a true challenge. They are monsters. They are uncivilized. They talk too much. They never study, and half of them are flunking. And you're part of it.
Gee, thanks. What do you feel about the class of 1987 as a whole?
I've had the class of 1987, some of you, about 5 times. I started with you in the 7th grade, 8th grade, 9th grade, 10th grade. I missed somebody in the 11th, but I picked them up in 12th. I've taught that class of students more than any other class. And I've finally gotten to understand them. There is little hope for them. I understand why their parents want to get them out of the house.
Well, what kind of advice do you give to them in the later years?
Save your money, vote Republican, and take care of the old teachers when they need to be taken care of.
All right, thanks a lot.